Hello. Hi, Priscilla. How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
Good. I'm Liana. Thanks for coming in. So I understand that you have some concerns about the chart reading section on the ACT that's coming up.
Yeah, the science part's pretty hard for me.
Not a problem. That was hard for me too, but I've planned a mini lesson that should help you feeling confident for that going into this test.
Perfect.
So to start today, I'm just going to go over a few key terms. Variables is something you want to keep in mind when going into the chart reading section. So what a variable is something that changes in the experiment. So for example, if you're going to track precipitation and how much it's raining, the variable would be how much it's raining each day. And you want to be very specific when explaining and writing down your variables because you want to say it's in inches, feet, or you know whatever instrument of measurement you're using. So on the chart, we're going to actually put it down into a chart so we can have a better idea of it and you can see it. I know I'm a visual learner and I'm sure it will help you solidify that. So on this chart, can you point out where the variables are?
The date and the precipitation.
Good job. Yeah, that's perfect. That's exactly it. So what a chart typically looks like, it'll have the name across the top, and then on the right side, it will have its first measurement. That'll be the first variable. And then the second category, or depending on how many, it'll be the second variable. So on this instant, we have the date and then the daily precipitation in inches. So just so I can double check and see where we're at, can you tell me on the second how much precipitation there was?
Looks like there is 0.04.
Perfect. Yeah, and that's in inches. So you'll want to always make sure to use that in inches or in feet or whatever they are using. And so on what day was there 1.0 inches of daily precipitation?
January 4th.
Perfect. And just another key thing I like to keep in mind when I'm reading charts, I always like to just find what they're asking and then go across so I can just keep it straight. So if they're asking for on the 1st, I go to January 1st and I just take my finger over and I go to daily precipitation and that gives me my answer right there. Sometimes that can make it easier when reading a chart. And just to make sure we covered all our bases here, I'm just going to check in with some questions. What are the units being used for the variable in this chart?
Looks like it said inches in the statement above.
Perfect. That is exactly what I'm looking for. And then just another question here. What else could you measure in an everyday situation? And what units would you use?
I mean, since we're in Minnesota, I'd probably track snow. Yeah, that's a good one. And probably do inches or how many feet it's been snowing.
Perfect. That is great. That's exactly it. Do you have any other questions on how to read a chart or anything else we can go over today?
No, I think that really helped me. Thank you.
You're very welcome. You did a great job.
Thank you.